We are back at the Radisson Blu Hotel, now specifically the Larder restaurant. And I'm here with this wonderful gentleman.
Yeah.
We call him Baba Emmanuel.
or you can call me Fred.
Oh, we can call you Fred.
Fred is okay.
Fred is okay.
Yes.
So today does not want us to call him Baba Emmanuel. But to me, that's how I'll refer to you.
No problem.
How are you today?
I'm fine, thanks. And you?
I'm well. I'm great. Thank you for hosting us here.
It's a nice morning. Yeah,
yeah, it's a wonderful morning.
Thank you.
It's a wonderful morning.
Yes.
So let's talk about the last time we were here, we were at the Chop House restaurant.
Yes.
And it's a specialty seafood and steak.
Mm-hmm.
So your restaurant here as a restaurant manager, what's your specialty at the Larder restaurant?
Larder is, our theme is a family style.
Okay.
It's a family style theme. Mm-hmm. So we are serving mostly continental with a touch of Kenyan and Indian. So we embrace all cultures, from South America, Asia, Africa, and Europe. So any guest who walks into Larder restaurant cannot miss anything from our menu.
Is it?
Which of course is wonderful. That's a plus we have in town, yeah.
So you cater to all, continental cuisine, international cuisines?
International, with touches, the local touches, because most guests would like to have what is authentic in the country.
Uh-huh.
If someone comes from Europe, he doesn't expect to get what he has there. You want to have the African touch, the Kenyan feeling, yeah?
Yes.
The githeri, the
you
mokimo.
Have githeri here.
Yeah, we do that.
No.
Yes, we do.
Eh.
Yeah.
So you even have like the authentic ethnic Kenyan dishes?
Exactly. And most of our dishes are more authentic with the home style, style of cooking.
Mm-hmm.
It's not the oily style of cooking, and we try as much as we can to engage our guests into our menu.
Mm-hmm.
So our serving staff are trained enough to go off menu with the guests.
Okay.
Provided the chef can accommodate what the guest wants, and
Are you serious?
Yeah,
so I can come here feeling like having lobster.
Yes.
And I'll have it.
The chef might will have something for you.
That is amazing.
Yeah.
I have not heard about that anywhere. Like, because most places stick to the menu.
We don't. We what we do is we offer, as I said in the previous show, we offer the Yes I Can service.
What is Yes I Can?
Yes I Can is, in simple word, is 100% guest satisfaction. That is what we do. When you walk into a restaurant, people are tired of reading through the menu, get for me what you have in the menu, and then it's done with that. Our waiting staff will take you outside the menu, but still accommodate the request of the guest into our menu. Yeah.
Wow, that is pretty amazing. So I'm still very fascinated by that whole not following the menu and your Yes I Can policy.
Mm-hmm.
Did you borrow that from the president of the state?
The previous campaign slogan for no. I think we are the first one who used it. The president, the former president, to be the former president of US, borrowed that from our slogan.
He knew that Radisson Blu has this slogan and he must use it in his campaign.
Exactly.
So funny.
I think it's more unique in a way that most of the clients we serve, and most of the clients who walk into hotel, they know what they want. If you walk into a hotel, you expect quick, accurate, and consistent service.
Okay.
That is what we offer.
Okay.
So
for example, if right now I feel like eating plantains, I will find them.
Oh, you will. Most definitely.
You're serious?
Most definitely.
That is pretty amazing. So your kitchen must be very stocked up.
If we don't offer what you want, we have to give an alternative.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
But there's no way I will leave this place without having something that I want.
You have to walk out 100% satisfied.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what are we having today?
What we're having today, our chef is doing Esso Kifto.
Who?
Esso Kifto.
Esso Kifto.
Yes.
Where is it?
Okay, in simple words, and I think the viewers will see it later, it's a whole tilapia marinated with Swahili spices. Just the home style of doing the tilapia.
Okay.
And I think tilapia is one of your favorite dishes.
Who said?
I guess.
Well, me, my favorite is frog. Don't even put me to tilapia right now. But I'll be interested in looking at how he does it.
That comes with the cream spinach and chapati. So you can see how we are embracing the, yes. The African and yes. the Kenyan into
yes,
our menu.
I see that.
Then for a whole tilapia, you need to engage it using your hands. So.
You engage the
tilapia using your hands.
Okay.
And then you're also doing the stuffed chicken breast with potatoes.
Okay.
So.
There's quite
excellent.
A menu there.
Excellent.
So maybe we should go on over to Chef to see how he's doing it.
Let's proceed, and I think the viewers will like what
we're doing. Okay, perfect.
Thank you.
I follow you.
So, as I was telling you earlier, our chef is doing a live cooking.
Hey, chef.
You can go around and engage the chef.
Good.
I'm engaging tilapia now, I'm engaging the chef.
Yes, exactly.
You like this word, engaging?
Chef Robert will show you how we do our esokifto.
Okay.
Stuffed chicken,
yes. And the
cottage
cheese.
All right. Good yes. to meet you, Chef.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much.
Very
so, Fred, I'll catch up with you at the table.
No problem.
When we're engaging.
Let's meet there.
Okay.
Karibu.
Asante sana. So, yeah. What do you call that process?
This is marinating the chicken.
Okay. With what?
With olive oil.
Okay.
Soy sauce.
Uh-huh.
Black pepper, corn.
Okay.
And some herbs, mixed herbs. With salt and a bit of salt.
Okay.
Yeah.
And this osokofito?
Esokifto. Esokifto is an Ethiopian word.
Esokifto.
Yeah.
Ethiopian.
Yeah.
It's what
the
does spice, it mean?
The spices from Ethiopia. Hot chili.
Oh, from Ethiopia.
Yeah. Now
so
that one I'm going to prepare the fish, the whole tilapia.
Okay.
Now you're blending the African cuisine. Everything at the ladder.
Oh.
So at least each and every taste from around the world and Africa, so that at least everybody is
catered for,
yeah.
Right.
Now I'm going to stuff the chicken with ricotta, spicy ricotta cheese. I'll use my knife here just to pierce in the middle so that I may stuff it. Is
a
deboning knife?
That knife may just.
No, I'm used to it.
Oh,
very
yeah,
simple.
You're the pro.
I'm the pro. Now I have my ricotta cheese here.
The who?
Ricotta cheese.
Stuffed ricotta cheese.
Yeah, it's cheese, light cheese.
Uh-huh.
Spicy, but spicy.
Oh, it's spicy as well.
Yeah. So I just stuff it.
How do you know when it's enough?
It bulges.
Is it?
Yeah.
When it is baking powder in this?
No. When I put it inside, I can feel it. You see,
oh,
you
yeah.
can see. It bulges.
Yes, it is.
Okay, it's okay.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm going to grill it.
Okay.
With some spices.
Some mixed spice, eh?
Yeah.
Okay.
Some salt.
Okay.
Soy sauce.
That's soy sauce?
Yeah.
Okay.
And I'm going to grill it.
What's the value of soy sauce in this process?
To add some
flavor?
Flavor.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So the pan is already hot?
Yeah, the pan is already hot.
Is that important?
Yeah, the pan should be hot first. The flavor comes out to the better flavor.
Oh.
Yeah.
As opposed to putting it in the
in
pan
the
cold?
Yeah.
Ah.
You get the best
yeah.
flavor.
So this is flambé?
Yeah, flambé. Yeah, there's
a lot afraid of flambé.
Lamb herring.
What is that you're cooking?
Lamb pairing. Worcestershire sauce. Worcestershire sauce.
What is that you put for it to flambe in?
The lamb pairing.
What is it?
It's
Oh, Worcestershire.
Yeah, it's a
how
sauce.
How do you pronounce it?
Worcestershire.
Worcestershire.
Yeah. Like Leicester.
Ah.
Leicester City.
That sauce that's bringing flambé.
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
I'm gonna put some more.
You know, water and oil.
Ah. Wow.
So after grilling it, I'll put it in the oven to cook for around 6 minutes.
Okay.
Then it will be done.
So why is it important to first grill it?
To seal the pores so that the juice does not come out from the chicken. Now you're sealing the pores.
Before you're taking it to the grill?
To the oven, yeah. But if you take it to the oven directly, the juice will ooze out.
Right.
Yeah, now we're sealing it on a very hot pan.
I've never known that.
Yeah.
So it has four.
So the juice is retained inside. All the flavor is inside.
And the aroma is really, really.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tantalizing. Wow. So what is this pan for?
This one I'm going to prepare grilled asparagus also, which will accompany the chicken.
Ah, some little veggies for
yeah,
that.
Yeah, vegetables
eh?
for the chicken.
Okay, all right.
Asparagus and grilled zucchini.
Zucchini.
Yeah.
Which is otherwise known as courgette.
Yeah, the courgette.
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh.
I'll use some butter.
Some butter?
Yeah.
Oh, nice, chef. That looks like it's very tasty.
Yeah.
Some
black
spice?
Pepper.
Oh, that's black pepper.
Yeah.
So how long have you been doing this?
Almost 10 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
And you enjoy it?
Yeah. Really enjoy it.
Yeah. This is your calling.
Pardon?
This is your calling.
My calling. I started when I was still young.
Yeah.
A little bit. In
You're
high
still
school.
Young, chef.
No, I eat well. I choose what I eat.
You must be, yeah.
Yeah.
So like when
so
you work at a hotel like this and you have all this fancy food, when you go home, what do you cook for yourself?
I don't cook. My wife cooks for me. There I just sit down.
And you're cooked for?
Yeah.
Hey, wait. Ebu, on that note, pitishia, we are Madam Salamu. Eh, ambia Madam nakusalimia leo.
Nakusalimia leo. Enjoy this meal.
Oh.
Via the screen.
Via the screen,
yeah.
I tell you.
Now the chicken is ready to be placed inside the oven.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the asparagus
also. And the
also.
Asparagus also is ready.
Hey, I need to taste some Ugandan asparagus. It
yeah.
looks very
yummy.
Very.
It's healthy. And we're going to serve it with the potatoes.
Okay.
Yeah.
What kind of potatoes? How are you going to prepare that?
The potatoes.
Uh-huh.
We're going to use gratin potato. I've already prepared it. Gratin.
Gratin.
Yeah.
Okay.
Slice of potatoes.
Uh-huh.
I slice them. I use butter, herbs, black pepper, cream. Then I cook it a little bit. Then I'll put it in the oven. I use cheddar cheese and Parmesan cheese.
Mm.
So the gratin is the browning
right.
of the potato.
Yeah, it feels
yeah,
like
it
a bit crunchy, yes.
Yeah. So it gratinates.
Hey, matams too. It gratinates.
Yeah.
Hey.
That's it now.
Okay.
Now, the other thing I was going to prepare is the esokifto now. The fish.
Hey, I thought this is
stuffed chicken. Esokifto.
Esokifto.
Yeah.
It has a very unique name.
It's a whole tilapia.
Oh, whole tilapia.
Yeah.
Marinated with Ethiopian
spices.
Okay.
Yeah.
Today I'm learning. Today I don't want to touch any knives.
Today you're learning.
Today I'm here learning from the pro himself. So what's your favorite food?
At home, I prefer woodland mushrooms and beans.
You
just
prefer what?
These normal mushrooms, the field mushrooms.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Mushrooms and normal githeri. Not these fancy things.
Githeri and mushrooms.
Yeah.
Why? That sounds very fancy. When you throw in mushroom over there, you know that.
Ndengu kamande, such things.
Those are the things you like.
But I cook it with the coconut milk.
Oh, you don't cook for yourself?
I don't cook, I just give instructions.
And they'll follow to the letter.
Yeah.
You just say that here. Now, maybe you don't even do that. And then you go home and then you'll be in trouble. Will you call somebody new?
Hmm?
Eh? So, spices again, black
spices
pepper.
Spices again. Now, they are hot chili.
Oh, there's
the
some
spices.
Chili to it.
Yeah. Now, to make it esokifto, it has to be spicy.
Uh-huh.
But when the guests come, we ask them if they want it spicy or just normal Kenyan way, the like Victoria.
So, esokifto is in your menu?
Yeah. One of the fast moving items.
Is it?
Yeah.
Wow. Which other one moves really fast?
Got a whole baby chicken, a spring chicken.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Some lemon.
Mm-hmm. So I think what we'll do, I will leave you preparing this one.
Yeah.
Let me be surprised. The other one, I'm pleased to see what you've done.
Yeah.
This one, let me look at it and wonder, how did it come out like this?
You'll just see it.
Yeah?
Wonder.
So you, I'll meet you at the table.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much.
Karibu. Okay.
Fred Engage.
Welcome back.
I'm from Engaging with Chef Robert.
I even ordered your favorite chocolate.
And I now thank you for that.
We've done this for a while now. I know most of your favorites.
Tell me which other one is my favorite.
As you indulge the fish, you also...
No, I'm indulging, not engaging.
You're indulging with the fish.
Fred, utadonesha maneno kwa hoteli.
Welcome back.
Thank you so much.
So what did you learn from the chef?
Iskofikto? What is it called?
Esokifto.
I don't know how we learned that.
You know, most restaurants, when you walk to restaurants, they do the fillet,
mm-hmm.
the tilapia fillet.
Okay.
But people like me, I have to trust my fish. I have to see the head.
mm-hmm.
Yes, so that is why we call it the family style.
Mm.
As in, if you walk in here on Sunday when you're doing the brunch, it's like the guests are cooking for themselves.
Is it?
Because we involve them in anything we do. We have the carving station, we have the ice cream station.
There's an ice cream station?
Yes. And then we have the kids area.
Mm-hmm.
It's like it's a family out day.
Mm.
So if on one Sunday you feel you want to hang out.
Yes. I feel like hanging out all the Sundays after church.
Come over here. This is the right place to be.
So it's a good thing you've said that because I want you to look into the camera.
Yes.
And let people know. Mm-hmm. If they want to make a reservation, if they want to come to this place, how can they get in touch with this restaurant?
Our social media platforms, we have the Facebook, mail address direct to Lada.
Tell them.
Lada.Nairobi, LARDER, .Nairobi, at Radisson Blu. Radisson Blu is one word, double S, BLU, .com. So on mail, I'll get it direct.
Is there a phone number?
There's a phone number, 0709-810000.
Are you sure?
Very sure.
Repeat it.
Very sure. 0709-810000.
Okay.
Yes.
So you've heard Baba Emmanuel, others known as Fred, and I have a new name for him, which is
Engage. AKA.
AKA Engage. You want to make a reservation, there's so much openness here, I think, and freedom for the patrons to order for what you want. And the thing I like most about this hotel, this particular restaurant, is the freedom it gives, you know, the patrons. You come with your family, no one disturbs you.
Exactly.
There's an aura of, the staff is very friendly as well.
Yeah.
Did I tell you how much I like your uniforms?
Oh, you did?
I totally love your uniforms for the service staff.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's quite something.
I think for someone who does service, the uniform creates the, how do you call it? The confidence.
Mm.
Like if someone tells you in the morning you look pretty,
yeah.
The dress is nice.
So is that what you're telling me or you're giving me an example?
I'm saying the exact thing. The whole day you'd be happy.
Yes.
And you'll be walking shoulders high.
Yes.
So it starts with the uniform.
Mm-hmm.
You have to make sure your people are comfortable.
True.
In what they work with.
Yeah.
They don't feel like they're exposing much or hiding a lot.
Yeah.
Yes.
Wow, I like that. You operate with a staff of how many people at this restaurant?
We have a staff of 18.
Mm-hmm.
At any given time, we are working with around 6 to 7, including the supervisors and other managers. So it's a whole day restaurant. You walk in, the service you'll get in the morning is what you'll get in the afternoon, is what you'll get in the evening.
And what time do you open and close?
We open, breakfast opens at 6:30. That's when we welcome the first guest, which ends at 10:30. Immediately we turn the restaurant to lunch.
Mm-hmm.
Lunch starts at noon until 3.
Okay.
So since it's a whole day restaurant, we don't close.
Yeah.
Any guest who walks in will have something. So from 3 to 6, guests can still sit and have something at Lada restaurant.
Okay.
Then from 6:30, we start dinner.
Okay.
We take our last order at 10:30.
Mm-hmm.
So you can imagine if you are around Upper Hill at 10:15,
you can
and
dash here.
You're feeling your stomach needs some refill, the right place is here.
So your last order goes into the kitchen at 10:30?
At 10:30.
Mm.
So after 10:30, you can sit until the
it's
time
up to you to leave.
Exactly.
Whenever you want to leave.
Exactly.
Amazing.
Yeah.
And then, but when patrons are here, even past 10:30, there's someone waiting on them as well.
There's someone. Actually, the service team who works in the evening leaves at 11:30. Mm-hmm. Then at 11:30, there are two people who are coming in a shift just to make sure that any guest who is left behind, the service is not compromised. So apparently, in quotes, it's 24 hours.
It appears as if that is the case.
So after you've had your steak, you can continue having a glass of wine.
Yes.
Until any time you feel like...
That you need to go back to your house.
Yeah, exactly.
Or back to the hotel room.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anywhere you want to go.
Anywhere you want to go.
Yes.
So how long have you done this? How long have you been in the hospitality industry?
Wow, a great question. Mm. I've done it for, let me say, around 8 years now. I started it in 2006,
okay,
where everyone else starts.
Which is where?
From service. I did service.
Oh.
So if any of my service team colleague is unwell, I can chip in and do the service.
Easily do that.
Exactly. Then just move to supervision, mm-hmm, move to assistant manager, then to the restaurant manager.
Wow, well done. And when did you join the Radisson Group?
We are part of the opening team.
Okay.
We are creating history here. When history will be written,
yes, I think you will be there.
I will be part of the history.
Yes.
We opened Radisson Blue November 2015. That was a soft opening. Mm-hmm. Then in January we did the grand opening, January 2016.
Mm-hmm.
So we've been in business for slightly more than 1 year, and I think Kenyans have received Radisson in a nicer way.
Yes.
And since it's the first property we are having in Kenya.
Kenya, yes.
I think the corporate office is thinking
of another.
Another, not thinking, we have another one.
Okay, coming up.
Coming up.
Mm-hmm.
Late February, early March.
Wow.
Yeah.
In which part of town?
In Westlands.
Oh.
We're having Park Inn by Radisson.
Wow.
So under this, the same umbrella, uh-huh, Carlson Razido.
Uh-huh.
But it's Carlson Parkin, sorry, managed by Radisson.
Yeah. Invite us for the opening.
That's the right place. Now, if we are in Westlands, that's where we'll hang around. If we're in Upper Hill, that's where we'll hang around.
I tell you.
And we're still thinking of exploring more in Nairobi. Nairobi has a lot of potential.
Clearly, and you must have been very successful. I mean,
People think that there are a lot of hotels coming up, but the potential in Nairobi is still big. We've not explored the bed capacity we need, and the demand for food.
This means food is ready.
Yes. Now, that's when I was telling you. Now we need to indulge.
Oh, thank you. Indulge and engage.
With the hands.
Yeah. Oh, with the hands.
Yeah. You were asking how many years I've been in hospitality industry and what made me to join hospitality industry. Hospitality industry is more dynamic.
Mm.
And it's something.
Hold that thought. Hey, Chef Robert.
My. The
stuffed chicken and breast. Cottage
cheese.
People enjoy it.
Amazing.
And Fred, people enjoy the esokifto.
Oh, my.
I'll also enjoy that as well, Kifto.
We'll indulge.
Oh, we will indulge, right?
Yes.
Oh, and it comes with ugali.
With ugali, so... Or chapati.
Nice.
Now you can see why we say we do the African with a Kenyan touch.
I see that.
Thank you, Chef.
We really appreciate. Oh, I'm sure we'll enjoy this, Chef. Asante
so
sana.
Where do you indulge from?
Where?
Mm-hmm.
First, kila mtu anze na yake.
Okay.
No, first, let me first indulge as you tell me your story of how you...
Why I decided to do hospitality.
Yes. Wait, which knife should I be using?
Any.
You're sure?
Any will do.
Okay. Uh-huh.
So, I felt hospitality is more dynamic. It's more... You feel like you are not doing the same thing every day.
Mm.
That is what you feel. Because every day in the morning when you come up...
This is very good.
It's good. Every day in the morning when you come to work, you find different clients with different demands.
Yes.
And when you help a client or when you solve a problem, you feel like you've accomplished.
Yes, there's a sense of achievement.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
So it's...
Mm.
And the creamy spinach. Did you get one?
Mm-mm. I have asparagus. Mm-hmm. But this is very good.
And the spices in the fish. I wish you could share.
I can just taste it. Mm-hmm. This is amazing. The flavor is something else.
Yeah. The fish is just great.
You have to be careful with the bones.
Yeah.
Okay, so every day you feel you've accomplished something when you help someone.
Yeah, and you're doing, you know, hospitality is like, how do you call it? It's like a call.
Mm-hmm. Mm, it's a call in your way. Yeah.
It's something you have to do from your heart.
Yeah.
If someone pushes you to jump into hospitality,
yeah,
I think that's
you can't succeed.
That's the worst decision you make with your career.
Mm. Is Kofikto?
Yes, Kofikto.
The escort. That one?
Yeah, perfect.
Mm.
And the spices?
Perfect. So much flavor.
So for some people like me, who doesn't believe it's fish until they see the head.
Now you believe it's fish?
Yeah.
Your the service right is excellent. Your food is beyond excellent.
Thank you.
I love everything about your restaurant. And there couldn't be a more perfect person running it.
Mm-hmm.
You're so full of life. Engage, indulge. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Involve.
Involve. You know?
Yeah.
And I'm looking forward to us even, you know, featuring more of your branches when they open.
Exactly.
And when they open.
That is our goal. Mm. By latest
March.
February or early March, I think our new sister unit will be up.
Okay.
The first in Kenya is doing great.
This one, where we are right now.
Yeah. We also have units in Addis Ababa.
Yes.
Ethiopia.
Okay.
Kigali, Rwanda. Mm. Kigali, we are having Radisson Blue and Pakin.
Okay.
Uganda, we are coming. Tanzania, Dar es Salaam.
So you'll be all over East Africa.
Yeah,
within
we want to make sure that East Africa is
your footprint is in every
branded
country.
By Radisson.
I hear you.
Yes.
And I wish you all the best.
Thank you very, very much.
And thank you so much for hosting us. Mm-hmm. I want to dig into this food. You know, usually I share with
and then,
my crew.
And then you involve with the fish.
And then I come and engage with yours. Yeah. But asante, asante sana.
Thank you.
If you'd like to make reservations to come to this incredibly beautiful, gorgeous restaurant, look for those numbers on our social media pages. Fred said them earlier on. Actually, they're running now on screen as I speak. Make your reservations. Walk in here on Sunday as well. Maybe you don't even need to make reservations. Just they can walk in, right?
They can walk in, yeah.
Yeah.
You know, this, walk in with the family.
Yeah.
And just surprise them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. This restaurant is located at Nairobi's Upper Hill area. It's very easy to find your way here. So that's been our showcase this week. Radisson Blue, the larder restaurant to be specific. If you have a restaurant and you want us to show up, let us know. Until next week, Mungu awabariki sana.